If you're seeking healthy products for your skincare needs, you'll want to visit HempEase.com. The fine folks at HempEase.com blend together 9 healing herbs that have been selected specifically to help reduce swelling, rejuvenate circulation, invigorate cellular growth, and stimulate deep tissue healing. When you visit their website, you will find a wide variety of great products, from body butter to body salves to fantastic hemp root oil that is just great for all parts of your body. And there's even something there for your special four-legged friends that everyone considers part of the family. So if you're looking for something that is made of organic healing herbs specifically designed for your body's needs, you'll want to visit HempEase.com. That's HEMP-EAZE.com.
Look at all that money, yeah, the money that they spent. Take another look now and take some time for him. Don't cut trees for paper, cause it hurts the environment. Stop deforestation, yeah, it's time for him. Oh, an acre of hemp makes 20 barrels of oil. Pesticides to poison all our soil. People got no food, they got no clothes, they got no rent. Well, right now it's time for hemp.
Well, hello, thank you for tuning in to the big broadcast here at Time for Hemp. We have a lot to talk about today, but before we kick off the show, as always, I want to say hello to my little sister, Lynette Shaw, and thank her for making this program possible on her broadcasting network. Lynette Shaw has been active in trying to end cannabis prohibition all around the world, and she also owns the Marin Alliance Medical Marijuana Dispensary, as well as this network. If you like this program, please find Lynette on Facebook, or maybe even find her in person if you can, and tell her thank you for all that she's done and for making our voice heard. And she is a dedicated individual. She's also a great singing performer, and if you get a chance to see her in concert, I would encourage you to do so. Thank you for tuning in to the broadcast today. We are focused on Captain Ed Adair and his friend Jack Hare. And I know many people out there know Jack Hare. Some people just know Jack Hare by the name as a strand that they smoke, right? So, but there's more to Jack Hare than that. If that's all you think Jack Hare is a strand that you smoke, then I guess you're going to be surprised at what you've learned here on the big broadcast. Please make it a point to go to Jack Hare's website and say hello to the people who operate that. Jack's no longer with us. We certainly miss him, and Captain Ed's no longer with us either. That's one of the reasons why this video is so, I think, important, because it preserves their comments and it preserves their intents and what they were trying to achieve with the book and with the organization that he and Jack established. And so that's what I also like about the archives that we have at the Time for Hemp Global Broadcasting Network. You can go there and check out all our archives and hear many of the founders of the cannabis movement from over the years as guests on the show. And we do ask that you visit the site very often and share it with your friends. We're going to be doing a lot of updates. It might not look like this when you go to it, and if it does, just know that we're going to be doing more updates soon. And we are trying to become a little more, new age. But nonetheless, one of the things that we are doing now is focusing our attentions on video. And we're doing music podcasts, and we're doing also Time for Hemp Tunes, which is cartoons about how important cannabis is. And of course, we're working on this show, Time for Hemp. So if you like what you're doing and what like what you're seeing, I mean that, if you like what you're seeing, please make it a point to find Lynette Shaw and tell her thank you for making it a possible for us to be part of this broadcasting network, and that you appreciate the content that is being heard loud and prouder on the Marin Alliance Medical Marijuana Broadcasting Network. So we love you, Lynette. Thank you very much for making this possible. Lynette and Captain Ed and Jack Hare were all very good friends. And as I've said before, Lynette sings and wrote the theme song for the Time for Hemp broadcast. And so that's what you hear at the end of each show. That's her voice. And we certainly love her. She's like a little sister to me. Anyway, I just want to let you know that we got a lot of other things going. We got a newsletter. We got a blog. We got MP3s you can download. We're on iHeartRadio. Anywhere there's sound to be found on the internet, we are there making sound on the internet. And we want the whole world to know how important it is to take, you got it, Time for Hemp.
Friedman Fitch Associates are financial advisors specializing in cannabis investing. You don't have to be a drug dealer to get rich from marijuana. Now you could get filthy rich from the stock market. In the last few years, 64 weed stocks have shot up over 1,000%. Why? Because the prohibition of weed is coming to an end. 29 states have now legalized medical cannabis. 8 states have legalized recreational use. It is estimated that $35 billion in new wealth will be created each year, causing the green rush. And smart investors are cashing in. So how do you become a smart investor? Easy. Talk to the number one financial advisor specializing in the marijuana industry. Friedman Fitch Associates aim to offer sound, well-researched advice rather than hype. Get rich the safe way. Invest in marijuana stocks with Friedman Fitch Associates. Go to FriedmanFitch.com and register for a free consultation. That's FriedmanFitch.com.
You are listening to the Time for Hemp Global Broadcasting Network. Please share us with your friends.
Blow, old Chinese man.
Eh?
What's that you're smoking?
That's a wicked eye grater from Gome de Pana Empress. You want to lick? See the chalice happy burn. Cannot be burned. Turn. Keep the ganja pipe burning. The good sense to me, a man yearning. A ganja man, they put you stiff in the air.
And a weary neck, you just don't care.
When we sing again, keep the ganja pipe burning. The good sense to me, a man yearning. A ganja man, they put you stiff in the air.
And a weary neck, you just don't care.
Turn. Wait there, yes, me have to crap it. Say it's a bad habit, but it make me fly like a rocket. Too much of anything will make you an addict. Yes, me feel stressed when me no have it. Come on, girl, I look good like Playboy Bunny rapids. Yes, me list 250 back me having on me pocket. Two slip chicken while me plucking a socket. Hot on me Guinness and me weak me a walk it, yo. Keep the ganja pipe burning. For good sense to me, your man yearning. A ganja man, they put you sniffing at the air.
And I weary like you just don't care.
Shiny man, I think. Keep the ganja pipe burning. For good sense to me, your man yearning. A ganja man, they put you sniffing at the air.
And I weary like you just don't care.
Good boy from overseas, we no care, we no matter. This will be get flatter, man, a real top of tapper. Big Mac, double whopper, original showstopper. No say man, I no rapper, but can't say man, I no shatter. Light up, we big it, make it bone down proper. One the time, we real root boy, used to real chopper. This the king, blow, oh, your head pan a platter. Smoke a slipper.
If you're seeking healthy products for your skincare needs, you'll want to visit hempease.com.
The fine folks at HempEase.com blend together 9 healing herbs that have been selected specifically to help reduce swelling, rejuvenate circulation, invigorate cellular growth, and stimulate deep tissue healing. When you visit their website, you will find a wide variety of great products, from body butter to body salves to fantastic hemp root oil that is just great for all parts of your body. And there's even something there for your special 4-legged friends that everyone considers part of the family. So if you're looking for something that is made of organic healing herbs specifically designed for your body's needs, you'll want to visit HempEase.com. That's HEMP-EAZE.com.
Listen, I think we all know what's wrong with this country, really, when it gets right down to it. Let's all say it together. The elderly. Anybody? Is that just me? That's just me. There's just too fucking many of them. There's too many of them. All the boomers who are getting old, and they're the only ones who vote. Demographically speaking, they're the only people in America who vote, the old people. Did you vote in the last election? Ugh. Holy crap. The stench of mortality hovering over that junior high gymnasium when you go to perform your civic duty. Because I get very excited. Like, I'm going to participate in my democracy. And then you get there, it's like, brrr. It's just... walkers with tennis balls on the bottom, sweatpants as far as the eye can see, smell of Polygrip. It's depressing. Listen, none of us is immortal, okay? We all love our grandmammies and our grandpappies. But at a certain point, you gotta take the keys away, right? I am sick of my life being determined by the votes of people who, quite frankly, aren't going to be around to suffer the consequences of what they are voting for, okay? I will fix this for future generations right now. If you are a teenager, not only should you get to vote, you should get 2 votes, because you're going to be alive that much longer to deal with the shit, right? If you're in your 20s, you should get 3 votes, because you're still young, but you're a little smarter at that point. In your 30s, 5 votes. 5. That's right. Because that is when you are at your best as a potential voter. Because when you're in your 30s, you're still young enough to have hope for the future, but you're not a fucking idiot anymore. Do you know what I mean? Like, when you're like 37, you don't say stupid young person shit like, why does there have to be war, man? Like, you get it, right?
Welcome back to the big broadcast. I certainly do appreciate you tuning in. And that's why, you know, we are getting stronger across the United States. More and more people are becoming aware of all the fabulous products that can be made from hemp and all the wonderful ways that people can heal when using cannabis as a form of medication. And we do believe that eventually there will be an end to prohibition all around the world. It takes you getting involved in your neck of the woods. If there's a national organization for the reform of marijuana laws somewhere nearby, you might ring them up and see if you can get active with what they're doing. If not, maybe start your own chapter. You can also get active on contacting politicians with letters and emails. They do pay attention to their constituents who vote. So if you are a voter, just sending in any type of correspondence, again, snail mail or whether it be email, they will make it a point to at least get back to you and let you know that you have been heard. You can also show up to town meetings and ask questions that are kind of a little uncomfortable, like, how is it that everybody knows about the products that can be made from this wonderful plant, but you, Mr. Politician or Mrs. Politician, how is it you're blind to that, you know? Or why is it that you think there's no value to cannabis when science and doctors have said that there is? You know, you can always go that route. There's a lot of ways you can get involved and make a difference and help end cannabis prohibition around the world. We do have a newsletter. If you would get a chance, go to our website and check it out. And if you like it, you can always subscribe to our newsletter. We've also got a blog there. We try to put a new entry there a couple of times a week. And let's see, we've got lots of archives. We're on iHeartRadio, Tumblr, SoundCloud, Roku TV. So there's a lot of ways of finding our content. And of course, now we are blessed to be part of the Marin County Television Network. Thanks to Lynette Shaw. Thank you, Lynette Shaw, for making it possible for us to be part of this broadcasting network with you. And that's how we are getting the archives out. I did promise all of my guests when they came on to the show that I would do what I could to help raise their voice so that everybody around the world would hear what they had to say about cannabis and the need to end prohibition. And this certainly is a way that I get to help, you know, bring that about. So again, thank you, and share us with your friends. We are doing the part two of the interview with Jack Hare and his buddy Captain Ed Adair. Captain Ed only made a few video appearances, and he was a loving man. I had an opportunity to be his friend and get to know him, and I certainly was blessed by his spirit, and I do miss him very, very, very much. So anyway, before I choke up much more, I love you, Captain Ed. I love you, Jack Hare. I miss you both. I certainly wish you were here in person to do a show with me, but it certainly was a wonderful experience to be your friend and to have learned from you both. And because of you, I'm working on still letting the whole world know how important it is to take time for it.
Boy, you really get around, don't you? You meet a lot of people.
I'll tell you, working in the hemp movement has taken me all over the world so far, and I'm loving it.
Even to Europe, right?
Even to Europe. With the
You've been all over Europe with Jack's book and this message.
I walked around all over Europe with a great big box full of 50 books of The Emperor Wears No Clothes, bumper stickers and buttons, and I stood up in Frankfurt, Germany, all over Germany, Paris, England, selling this book and educating the Europeans.
And now we're in the Hemp Museum over there, right?
Yeah.
We're in the Hemp Museum over there.
Yep.
Okay, now I understand you're doing not just one, but two initiatives that you're working on. You're doing the hemp initiative to legalize hemp cannabis as a product, crop and so on. And then there's this one for the fully informed jury. I guess the jury has to be told if they can change laws or something.
Well,
or
what's all jurors knew this information until 1967. When you served on a jury, you knew that if there was a bad law or you thought it was a bad law, or you could listen to the defendant's motives, you could vote down a bad law. It was our protection. Before we had a Bill of Rights, we had this law
that
I know we're not supposed to know. Since 1967, over a 1964 case, the government has outlawed that you find out or know that you have this right or you can't serve on a jury. When you serve on a jury, the judge asks in voir dire that he says to you that if any of you disagree with the law or as law is written, you must excuse yourself from the jury because you must follow the law as written. If any of you think that you can go your own way, then you cannot serve on the jury. Well, until 1967, that was a lie. Every juror knew that he had the right to overrule the judge.
What do you mean?
Well, the first rule in the law, from the Peter Zenger case in 1735, where the jury overruled the Crown when the Crown said you couldn't say anything bad against him, and the jury came back innocent because he had told the truth about the Crown, until John Jay and Tom Jefferson said you've got to have juries as the final check and balances on the executive, legislative, and judicial branch.
Okay.
So what we've done is we're not changing any laws. We are proposing a constitutional amendment for California, and we hope for a model for the whole United States. And all it does is redelineate and tell what rights you have as a juror that's already the law, but if you know you have this right now in California, you can't serve on a jury. We're making it so you can have this right and know you have this right and serve.
If you know you're right.
If you know you have this right, you can't serve on a jury. It is your right. So
now it's Republican to me.
It sounds like catch-22 to me.
In Kentucky, aren't they using this law
now? Well, half of all the prohibition cases in the 1920s and 30s ended in hung juries because the juries knew this, and the prosecutor and the government stopped prosecuting.
That's happening in Kentucky right now.
On a rowing case. The purpose of this act is to assure that jurors are made aware of, A, the juror's inherent right to judge whether the law or laws applicable to the case being tried are unjust or misapplied. B, the juror's traditional right to vote according to conscience. To this end, juries affected by this act shall be allowed to hear evidence concerning the defendant's motives. Whenever state or local government is one of the parties in any trial by jury, the court must inform the jurors that in addition to their responsibility to judge the facts of the case, they have the inherent right to judge the law itself. Well, now that you heard it, you already know you have this right, and it doesn't matter whether you vote for it. It's your law. This is your right. Ha. And the government took it away from you, and if you know you have this right, you can't serve on a jury.
That's
well,
insane.
You guys can't serve on a jury now unless you lie to the judge.
Some of you might think
you want to get excused from juries, but that's how we're making bad laws. The reason was so that bad government employees or a bad public policy, judges, legislators, cops could not pass a bad law for things that displease them and then grab up 12 of us and make them rubber stamp this bad law on our neighbor. We had a way out. We could say, hey, jury nullification. One of us could hang a jury or all of us could come back innocent and that person would go free because there was a bad law. Who would say to a person who's giving his child, for instance, marijuana for his asthma, where the kid's going to live a lot longer than if he uses the legal government medicine, when he can tell the jury that, what jury's going to come back and convict this person? Nobody's going to convict this person. Well, so the law doesn't want you to find out this information, so you can't hear defendant's motives. Under this, you will hear defendant's motives, and you can go according to conscience.
Wow.
I mean, who would rather see a kid die than get well and get high?
Really?
You know, for asthma. And live 6 to 12 years long. Go home and tell your mama that you want to die 6 to 12 years sooner so you can be a good government person for Bush and Bill Bennett.
Dan Quayle probably smoked your stuff.
In fact, I'd like to see him on a lie detector test.
Okay, now how many signatures do you need for the Hemp Initiative and for the jury rights initiative?
385,000 valid voter signatures in California for the Hemp Initiative and 595,000 for the Jury Rights Initiative, which is a constitutional amendment and requires more signatures.
We have hundreds
of people out now petitioning. We're training them to get good signatures in the first 10 days now. But the initiative goes on to early July. We have the time to collect good signatures and teach petitioners. And when we're done, Captain Ed and I have always hoped to have an army of petitioners of 1,000 or 1,500 people that one day are trained from day
freedom
one.
Freedom fighters.
Freedom fighters and reefer raiders, maybe. Ronald Reagan said reefer people could never make the ballot, that our minds are too slow. Well, Ronnie, my mind's not too slow, and I don't have to read my lines.
That's right.
Now, do you think you're going to succeed?
Nobody can beat the truth. Can anybody beat the truth?
Absolutely not. Way, man.
This man and I have been out there telling the truth, and nobody's ever said we're wrong. They keep arresting us 33 times. They have beaten us in jails. They have done physical things to me I'm not going to describe on this air, but there's nothing that can beat a fact, and I don't care how popular a president thinks he is, when people realize that he's killed off a planet and he's killed off the knowledge of a planet, and he's allowed millions of people to die prematurely and in pain and in misery, and has ruined the quality of life that can be gotten with a good, simple medicine that never killed anybody except at the hands of bad public policy and police carrying out bad public policy with a vengeance.
Get down, dude. Say it like it is. Yeah. Now, if someone wants to say, I want a petition, right?
Yeah.
They want to get involved with this. How do they do it? Who do they contact?
They go to 6702 Van Nuys Boulevard, 6702 Van Nuys Boulevard in Van Nuys, California.
Okay.
And they go to H&H, or they come to 39 Park Avenue in Venice.
All right.
Or call 213-392-1806. 213-392-1806.
All right.
And then you can petition for us. We'll teach you how to petition. We'll put you out in the field. We'll train you. We'll stay out there. We'll keep you all night at the 7-Elevens and the house getting signatures. and you'll get the munchies legally.
Okay. Now, what are you going to do after you get all the signatures collected? What do you do with them? And then what's the process?
Well, we make sure that all the bad signatures are weeded out. They're not necessarily bad, but if the petitioner doesn't know the rule, for instance, if somebody signs a petition, Ben Franklin, we have to find out how he spells Franklin, with a Y or an I.
Okay.
And then we say, did you have a middle initial? He says, oh, yeah, I had an M. And is your name Benjamin or Benji, or was it really Ben or Benet? Oh, no, it's Bennett. So we have to find out that information. We have to elicit that. So we get on the petition, on the printed part, Bennett M. Franklin, so they can look up the scribble. They can't even read the scribble of the signature, but they have to have the printed material right. They have to have the address right.
All right.
And that's what we teach. And that's what we do. We look for petitions that are really good and clean, and the ones that are totally unreadable, we
and
get
rid of. And they have to be registered voters.
They have to be registered voters and sign it on their own county sheet.
All right. Gentlemen, I have really learned a lot and had a lot of fun having you both on the show.
Right.
It has been exciting and interesting. I hope that this initiative just skyrockets. Yeah. I understand it's a blueprint for the nation, right?
Yes. Have you seen the back of our shirts?
Nah. Check it out. Paper, fiber, fuel, all the things that you can do with it, right?
Uh-huh.
It's a teaching T-shirt.
Uh-huh.
And
yeah,
pretty much says it all.
Yeah. And here are the health statistics. You live longer if you smoke pot than if you do no drugs. Uh-huh. And 8 to 24 years longer than people that use alcohol and tobacco.
All right. Well, again, remember the next time that you see me coming across your television screens, you'll know that it's time for hemp. Thank you for tuning in. And remember, only you and I and our brothers and sisters together can make this wonderful plant legal.
Re-legal.
Re-legal again.
Re-legal.
Give you all the lowdown. It's a mess, too. Tables were filled with gaudy frails chewing on their fingernails. They were waiting for the man from Harlem.
Ah!
Oh, there! Drinks were served, 6 bits of throw. Things were moving kind of slow.
Look at all that money, yeah, the money that they spent.
Crop King Seeds, we sell the finest marijuana seeds in the world. Grown organically with original genetics, every seed is cultivated for large yield, high THC content, and measured for both CBD and CBN levels. Did we mention we sell more than 20 of the world's best marijuana strains in feminized, auto-flowering, medical, and regular varieties, including White Widow, Blueberry, Purple Kush, Haze Extreme, and so many more? Through our website and friendly call support team, our seeds are available for direct order with speedy worldwide shipping. Crop King seeds are also sold in over 100 locations worldwide.
Excuse me, I'm looking to buy some Crop King seeds?
Look no further, my friend.
Wow, they're here and in so many strains.
Buy your seeds now, in-store or online at cropkingseeds.com. Or call us toll-free at 1-844-CROPKING. That's 1-844-276-7546.